He starts it up at the end, he starts it up.
Did he say how much he had into it? 100 and something thousand, right? He said he had 150 grand into it, right? But if you think about it, that's not really, you know, that big of a deal to have that much into it, because Jim's got that much into his LeMond, you know. If you look at that LeMond, you can tell it's a long haul.
paint or something? As I know it, I'm gonna fucking make 10 times more. Show movies coming out. You're probably saying that. I'm waiting for you to say it. You're dreaming, brother. You're dreaming. Got the phone entry shit. You Melody. I'm gonna go. You put one of yours on me. You put one of them. You put one of them on me. Rome calls me, leaves the answer, can I call her back?
I found my call, but it was sold. I found it.
It's in West Springfield. I call her back. I'm in the shower or something. Then I call her back, I say to her, so what are you doing now? You almost got a call. Well, there's everything I wanted, but when we called Monday morning, Sunday it wasn't there in the lot. So when we called Monday morning, it was sold. It was for $30,000. No, $25,000 at 30,000 miles. I think it's an SUV. I barely put a car as close to the vehicle as it was. But she sounded like she was all excited. You know, I think the car said, I go to Lumi this weekend. You're going to look at that car again. They don't try them on, and they just look at them. I didn't get the shop in the window shop, they call it. I told her, take one of the cars. You can't go over the salvage title. You ain't going to get nothing for that one. Take one of your other cars, tell them you want $2,000 trading or you ain't making a deal, and they'll knock down $2,000 off the price. You know that. They always got money to play with car lots. You know? Oh, yeah.
That's why, I mean, I would send her to Amanda's, you know? Sell her Amanda's car.
Oh, I said to Gilbert on the way home from the studio, I go, I can't sing your song. What is it? On the road again. I said, not on the road again. The song changed. I didn't tell her Julio that one though. But Gilbert, he had heard him, boy. He's unbelievable. Oh, he is. He's unbelievable. I said, go to New Bedford. You got the time fixed now.
Thank you. that was the story. She
I thought I asked her to get a record for driver
Yeah, she did. But then it's a release. It's a rest and release. The same thing that happened. I don't know why they put him in a... I don't know why they brought him downtown. They didn't have to do that. It's a, you know... As long as there's no warrants out, then it should have been just a... an arrest and release right there. With a $100 fine or whatever. You don't even have to appear in court. You don't, unless you're going to not pay the fine. If you want to fight it, you can go to a court. But you're never gonna win anyway. You waste a day's pay being out of work, and it's a pain in the balls. And then, you
like
know.
Like I told Gilbert, don't even worry about your license. You can pull over, you pay a fine.
Yeah.
The last time you got pulled over, you said.
Yeah, I mean they have what's called multiple offenders, where once you get caught 7-8 times, you know, so shit like that, they'll definitely bust your balls even more.
Yeah.
They'll you know, lock you up. Put you away for not, driving without a license. It's just really stupid. Makes no sense. But you guys could have done something about that over the last 50 years. Nobody, everybody would say, hey, you follow the rules. Follow the rules. There was no fishing without a license. You gotta go fishing, you gotta get a license. Ridiculous. No, I just searched the whole box. It's missing.
sun's up my camera now again. Fuck it. Okay, we're gonna go back with this bitch again.
I wonder what Amanda's car is real. What is she's gonna probably sell.
Oh, I forgot to even ask what kind of car it was. And Melanie kept asking him stuff. He was trying to talk to me, and Melanie kept saying this, trying to do this, trying to do this. But he said, "No, I gotta go. I'll talk to you after." I'm desperate. I told Matthew, take your motor, put it in that red Trans Am, throw the nose on it, you have a car to have some fun with, goofing around with. He didn't say no more. You already got the motor right there on the ground. You gotta take the other one out of the sand. Why cut your white car?
Neato.
don't you just make spaghetti meatballs for your father's son? That'd freak him out. And have cabbage in it, and give him cabbage soup. Remember the Polacks used to make cabbage soup? With potatoes and carrots. Or maybe no carrot.
That's,
onions and potatoes.
That would be new because he's never wanted those things before. Is that what he wants now?
What?
Spaghetti and meatballs?
No, I'm joking with you. Oh. It seems like Amy's passing a buck to you. She just made them gonkies last month.
Yeah.
Then after he's telling me, I feel sick. I think I ate too many.
She probably didn't put no pork in them.
I know. I don't know. I made it with the pork. I couldn't tell any difference.